Hey guys, my name is Eric Stenman. I'm the chief engineer here at Red Bull Studios Los Angeles. Welcome to our spot. So this is the Los Angeles studio. Red Bull actually has 12 studios in total around the world. The program reaches from here in Los Angeles to New York, to London, Copenhagen, Amsterdam, all the way down to Tokyo, Sao Paulo, Auckland, Cape Town. I'm forgetting a couple, but yeah, so 12 studios in total. We do a lot of tracking of live bands of all sorts, whether it's string sections or punk rock or you name it. So having a personal monitor system really helps out when, you know, I can just be sending the signals out and then letting the artists all dial in their own mixes. It saves me a headache, and then once people get the process down, it really lets them just, create their own comfort zone. So we've had our P16s about a month. They're getting rave reviews, both from the engineering side and the artist side. They sound clean. There's more features on them than I really expected, and so it gives a lot of flexibility as far as however involved you want to be with dialing in your own mix, during tracking. So they've been great. So on a day-to-day basis, our mission can be very different. We a lot of people hear that Red Bull has a recording studio and they picture a voiceover booth for TV commercials or something. While we do voiceovers occasionally, it's a music studio. So we always are working with very different types and talent, different levels of people as far as where they are at in their career. But a personal monitoring system like the P16 is something that pretty much everyone's going to be really hands-on with and be using anytime we're tracking here. So, a situation where these really get used would be, say, you're tracking a live 4 or 5-piece band. We can set a collection of these up out in our tracking room. Everybody can have their own mixer. A lot of times in the old days of studios, the drummer and the bass player might have to share a mix, and the bass players keep saying, "Why is your kick drum so loud?" And the drummer's saying something about, "I still can't hear the vocal." You got these, everybody can just really be in their own headspace, in their own world. They're not interfering with anyone else, and once they get the hang of it, they can just kind of go as deep down the rabbit hole as they want, as far as these have the EQ, a bit of limiting, so they're really flexible. This is Eric from Rebel Studios saying thanks to Behringer for stopping by.